Well, he got it after me, so I think I should have been invited on that basis, especially as my daughters can get married at Westminster Abbey.
You know, that's his a great privilege.
His daughter, you know... His daughter will be able to, but he's got, you remember, he's got three sons. She's pregnant at the moment. The rumour is that she's now, the next one will be a daughter. She will be allowed to.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Now, Tony Gramsci asks, how much of the taxpayers' money was used for the wedding?
The Queen and Prince Charles are paying some of it out of their personal fortune.
Okay.
The figures have never actually been released as to exactly what. It will be allocated from the civil list based on the proportion that the taxpayer contributes.
Okay, now this is very interesting. Ivan Trekkie asks, why is the royal family prohibited from marrying a Roman Catholic? Are they?
Yes, under the Church of England.
Oh my gosh, oh, yes. Really? So two things, divorced and Roman Catholic.
They're not prohibited, but... The question would then be, would they retain their royal position? Because under the Church of England, I mean, this is historical, back donkey's years. Historically, they have to marry
an Anglican,
a Protestant, anyway.
Okay.
Not necessarily an Anglican, because there are other...
So technically, I can marry a prince.
If you're a Protestant, you can. You are?
Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, I'm Protestant evangelical.
No problem.
Oh, but then I'm married, so...
So
the divorce factor.
Then the divorce factor will come into it, and you're
I'm happy.
But you're in big trouble because he might lose it being a prince, and you may not make it to princess.
No, but I'm curious. During the time of Prince Edward, was that Prince Edward with a divorcee?
Oh, you mean King Edward?
King Edward.
He became king
for a while.
King George V. His real name was David. He became King Edward the VI. He was a bachelor. It was then it came out that his love of his life was this Mrs. Wallis Simpson, this American divorcee. And now, then he had to abdicate.
Now, if it were today, do you think the British public still cannot take a divorcee?
Oh, I think let's say that the Queen had died and Charles had come to the throne as King Charles and she would have been Queen Diana. The divorce may have happened after that, although I think there'd be a lot more pressure for them to stay together.
Okay.
But now, it wouldn't have changed the situation with him being a king.
All right.
But Camilla would never have been queen. Now, she probably won't be.
Okay. Now, I know you have to leave, but I need to ask you this. Why don't they use their family names? People ask that all the time. Their family name is Windsor.
Windsor. The House of Windsor. But, I mean... It's even crazier than that, because somebody asked me the other day, what will be Catherine's title on marriage?
Yes.
Now, everybody thinks it's going to be Her Royal Highness Princess Catherine of Wales. It's not.
Oh, really?
She's going to be Princess William of Wales.
Why is that?
Because he's the prince. She will be Princess William of Wales after 11 o'clock in England today. But when he becomes king, she will become Queen Catherine. But Catherine will not be part of her official title.
Yes.
She will be Princess William of Wales. That is the extraordinary. No, the Windsor side has never been used.
So now, I'm curious, if you meet her, what will you call her?
At the moment, you would, Your Honour.
No, let's say she married William already, and you met her. What would you call Catherine?
Oh, well, Your Honour.
Your Honour.
Yeah, you wouldn't
not
get
Your
it.
Majesty.
Oh, no, that was the Queen.
That's for the Queen.
Yes. But if she became queen, then...
And you can't call her Princess Catherine. You can't.
Well...
It's weird.
Off camera, you probably can. But, I mean, I met Princess Margaret a number of years ago, and I called her Princess Margaret, and she had no problem with that, and I met the Queen Mother, but there I call her Majesty.
Okay. All right. Now, so why don't they use their family name? You just don't?
No, well, it's based on the titles that they're actually given. Of course, William is Prince of Wales. And of course Charles was Prince of Wales, so the Windsor is the family name. It's just like the same comparison could be said, that the Queen's real birthday, the day she was born, was in April, and that was last Maundy Thursday was her actually 85th birthday.
Yes.
But her official birthday is the day she became Queen, the coronation day, so she has an official birthday in June. So they could say, why does she have two birthdays? It's a bit similar, that's the family personal name of Windsor, the House of Windsor. But based on the titles they have, and Prince of Wales is Charles, and Prince William of Wales, so she's going to be Princess William of Wales, at least until he becomes king, and then she'll be queen.
Okay, before you go, I just want to let you know that people are telling me that you are the most informative of many of the people that have spoken about the royal wedding and the history of the royal family. So, good for you.
I have an advantage. First of all, at my age, I remember the king dying in 1952, and I remember the coronation. As a little boy, we were all given free mugs and a little gold cake carriage. I've still got them. They're very valuable to me. And, of course, I've seen all of the events of the royal family, really, since the 50s.
Wow.
All the way through Princess Margaret, Townsend. So I obviously know all of that. The big advantage is that I, having got the OBE and gone to Buckingham Palace and have met all the royal family.
Yes. So what should I call you, sir?
Well, I'm very the wonderful thing about living in the Philippines, I'm called Sir Leslie anyway. But in England, I'm not allowed to be Sir Leslie Stokes. So that would only be a knight commander. No, I'm playing Mr. Leslie Stokes, I can assure you.
All right,
please. But my daughters can be married in Westminster Abbey. And my wife cannot wait to show them there.
Oh, absolutely.
They're going to put pressure on me then.
No, Leslie, I want to thank you for coming over today. You're
Karen,
really the hot copy today.
No, well, that's been real
pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.